loves, welcome back to my channel. Welcome if this is your first time here. My name is Day, and if you like these types of videos, if you love lock videos, then this is the channel for you. Please stick around. And for those of you who have been here, thank you guys so much for coming back to see me. Today we're going to be discussing how to use oils properly on locks, natural hair, but mainly locks, really. I don't feel like there is a lot of information like this on YouTube. I feel like people who have locks and who give advice about locks, we pretty much say, you know, oil them, keep them moisturized, spray them, oil them, and that's kind of it. But nobody really talks about like the different types of oils that you can use and how to use those oils. So I want to just break down like some of the things that I've learned, because I've made a lot of mistakes with oils. The good thing about oils is usually oils can't really damage your hair. You know what I mean? Like there's some oils that are good for your hair and there's some oils that may not necessarily be so good for your hair, but it's easy to make mistakes with your hair using oils, and it's reversible. Like it's usually not that big of a deal. So let's talk about oils. Are used to seal in moisture, not to be mistaken with the idea that oils cause your hair to be moisturized, but they are a sealant. So you always want to use your oils on top of water. And I know that sounds like obvious, like an obvious thing, but that's something that I didn't know, because growing up, you know what I mean, I used to use grease on my hair. We didn't put water on our hair first. We used to grease our scalp, our parts, and we called it a day. But when you have locks or when you have natural hair, you have to spray your hair with water first or some type of like water-based product. A lot of people use rose water. I use both. I use natural water usually, and then rose water sometimes, mainly because rose water is like a little pricey. Always use water, clean water to start off with when moisturizing your locks. And then whatever oil you use goes on top of it, and it seals in the water, seals in the moisture. So that is key. I feel like everyone needs to know. And then you go into which type of oil is best for you and your hair type. Now this is something as well, I feel like it took me a while to learn. In my first journey, I used coconut oil. It was cheap. It was, you know, it was thin, it was available, and that's what I used. It worked for me. There are some people who really, really do have a negative reaction to coconut oil, and in turn, it dries out their hair instead of moisturizing it. I never had issues with coconut oil drying out my hair, but there are some people who stated that coconut oil can cause buildup in your hair, and I can see why. Coconut oil solidifies, of course, under a certain room temperature. And there are some theories that if you use it in your hair, it can kind of solidify in your hair. That is not the reason why I got rid of the coconut oil, but I just felt like, you know what, there has to be some other type of oils that I could use that, you know, maybe better for me. And that's what I did in this journey. In my last journey, I never did that. So I started trying out different types of oils, and I realized that the best way to do things is to have three specific oils. So I have an oil for every day, which is usually my lightest oil, because I'm using it to moisturize, not necessarily like every single day, but maybe every other day, just your daily oil. this one is going to be your lighter oil. So I have used argan oil, which is very thin. And of course you want it to be thin because you're using it often and you don't want it to cause buildup, right? And then you're going to choose an oil that is going to be for your retwist days. I retwist with oil and water. So my retwist oil is going to be a lot thicker because it's supposed to be holding. I say holding because nobody's retwist. Who just retwists with oil? It doesn't really hold, but it's going to be holding your retwist, right? You're holding your locks in place. So you want that oil to be a little bit thicker, and that's not going to be an oil that you use every day. It's going to be an oil that you use maybe like once a month or every few weeks or something like that. And then you can have an oil that you use for like restorative purposes, like a hot oil treatment, you know, something that's really going to keep your hair, you know, give your hair like that bounce back that it needs if you're having like a rough time or a dry time or whatever. So I use hemp seed oil all the time, argan oil all the time. Love it in combination with rose water. Those are my light oils. They're super thin, but they're moisturizing, and that's what works for me. For my heavy oil, my retwist days, I use Jamaican black castor oil. Jamaican black castor oil is thick. It's like it almost looks like a syrup. When you have it, and it's like this dark texture, it's very, very heavy. Of course, that's why you don't want to use it every day. And then for my hot oil treatments, I kind of do like a blend. Sometimes I will actually use Jamaican black castor oil, but I use vitamin E oil a lot. And I do want to try out a couple different oils as well, like the grapeseed and other things that I've seen that work. Tea tree oil is really good for itchy and dry scalp. I will say the tea tree oil as well can be very drying. A lot of people use tea tree oil on acne. I've used it on, like, you know, zits on my face, and it'll dry my acne out. So that's, you know, nice to use if you have like some type of like flaking and things like that in your hair. Only for the scalp, I personally wouldn't put tea tree oil down the length of my locks. But once again, that's my hair. So, and even though I use a thin oil daily, if I go in the mirror and my hair looks like it could use a little bit of moisture or a heavier oil, I'll use a heavier oil that day and sometimes even mix it with my thin oil and put it over, you know, my locks. I really focus most of my oil on the loose parts of my locks, which is like all this like puffy stuff right underneath here. That's the part that I really, really want to oil the most. And sometimes I will just rub it on my hands like this and just bring the remainder down the length of my locks. And then I'll focus a little bit on my tips. It's really not all that necessary to take a whole lot of oil and press it into your locks, because you do have to know that oil, just like any other product, can cause buildup if you overuse it. It's not as easy, like it doesn't easily cause buildup like some like creams and stuff like that, but it can if you use too much of it and if you're using like oils that are too heavy on your hair. After oiling your hair may be a little bit damp, so I wouldn't go ahead and put a scarf on right away or a bonnet on right away. I kind of let my hair dry out before I do that. So maybe like a couple hours before bed is like when I moisturize it, or sometimes when I first come in the house, I moisturize it. And then that way, by the time I'm, you know, going to sleep for the night, it'll be like dry and I can put my scarf on, no problem. Because you never want to put a scarf on or a bonnet on wet hair. In terms of how often you want to moisturize your hair, at least once a week, in my opinion. At least once a week. There have been times in my journey where I moisturize every day just because I needed to, especially if I colored my hair. I'm going to moisturize it every single day because my hair was dry. Other times I can skip days. There's no like complete answer to that. You have to study your hair and maybe like try different things. Maybe 1 week moisturize your hair every day and see if like that benefits you. Maybe another week just moisturize it twice in the week and see how that affects you. I've tried it out before. I moisturized my hair like twice in a week, once or twice, and I didn't really like the way that my hair was looking in between moisturizing, so that's why I moisturize multiple times a week. So yeah, everything is trial and error when it comes to the lock journey. The great thing about oils is you really can do it without causing damage. So try all the oils, you know what I mean? And find something that you love. Eventually you will find something that you love and that you're probably gonna stick with for a very long time. So that's all I have for you guys. Thank you all so much. Of course, if you have any additional questions, drop them down below or DM me on Instagram, Daylocks. I appreciate you all and your support, and I will see you in my next video.